David Navara joins us in our studio after his draw against China's Leitingye. The game looked pretty level throughout, but in fact, David tells us that it was full of tricks in the end. Have a look. David, a draw today against China's Leitingye, even though the game looked like it was peaceful throughout, there was a bit of complication at the end.
Yes, I misplayed the opening, after which I was slightly worse, but then I equalized I expected it to be a quick draw, but then I decided to play on because there was a nice trap at the moment when I avoided an exchange of queenside pawns.
Maybe you can show it to
us.
Yes,
I can show it. I mean, of course, it's a dead draw, but in this position, I played rook c4, hoping that rook d8 could happen, because then I can take on c5, and black remains a pawn down.
Queen e1 can be
queen e1 can be met with queen f1 when it should still be a draw after d1, but
you at least have an extra pawn and some chances.
Exactly. And okay, after rook e8, it's of course equal, but towards the end it was getting dramatic at this point, because now black needs to be really careful, as c2 probably loses to a7, c1 queen, check, and rook a7.
This is quite beautiful. So you mean where Tingye went queen a7?
Yes,
here you had a trick. If she goes c2, it's black is in trouble here.
Yes, but sorry. There are more tricks, actually, because after rook a2, black cannot... still here. If black plays rook a5, there's queen d7 winning.
This is a beautiful move.
Yes.
So the point is that if you take... you can, even if you go rook b5, you've got rook a8 and your queen first.
Yes, exactly. And after rook a7, I believed to be much better for a very short period of time, for several seconds before spotting c2, because black cannot play, for example, rook c5 when queen e3 can be met with rook c7.
But queen b7?
Instead, there's queen b7, rook c7, queen takes c7. And now white is winning. But in the game, there happened c2, after which it is just a dead draw. Rook takes c2, queen takes a6.
So she very precisely navigated from these tricks that you had at the end.
Yes.
And what are your impressions so far about the way the games have been going for you?
Okay, I disliked the way how I misplayed the opening today. But otherwise, I like my games. I think yesterday I displayed a good technique.
Yes, and you're back in Gibraltar. You feel good coming here?
Yes.
It's one of your tournaments that you start the year with quite often.
Yes, you're right.
We're very happy to have you here with us, and thank you for giving us your time.
Okay, thank you for your attention. See you later.
David, before I let you go, I have to ask you, when we were analyzing with Yufa earlier, with Daniel Yufa,
yes.
You were watching the analysis, and you spotted a mistake in his analysis at that moment.
Yes.
Or were you following the game when he was actually playing?
No, I had not been following it before, but I spotted the mistake in the analysis. That's what I often do. I mean, even when I was watching some really high-level blitz games, I very often spotted mistakes. But the problem is that when I am playing myself, I am making even more mistakes and also spotting them very soon, which does not improve my mood. So.
David, you're very modest, but we're sure that's not the case. And we really hope to have you back in our studio. Thank you for your time.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
See you later.
See you.